c4, e5, g3, knight f6, bishop g2. So in the previous chapter we discussed this very interesting move h6, which for the moment I don't see how white can really punish us for that. But maybe more solid and more logical move is to play here c6. The point is that, of course, always good to close this bishop, to stop it, stop its activity by building strong center with c6 d5. And that's a move more even popular with black, and it's quite complex game after that. The point for white, they should actually, if they simply allow us to play d5, then of course we are fine. So they should in a way or another try to attack the center. First we will examine this move knight f3, which I don't think it's the best one, but still we have to take it into consideration. Especially many strong players played it with white, like Leko, Navarra and so on. Here we have the possibility to attack immediately the knight by playing e4, knight d4 and d5. cd5, queen d5. Again, we are using our tempos. We take this important initiative, opening initiative, by playing very fast in the center. So after queen d5, he has a few retreats of the move of the knight. For example, if he goes with the knight to c2, then after knight c2, we go queen h5. With very clear idea, bishop h3, and with similar ideas like in Rosolimo, but without, of course, taking on c3 the position, but similar ideas. Here, after queen h5, Navarra against me, he played d3, the game went bishop h3, bishop h3, queen h3, knight e3, knight a6, d4, rook d8, queen c2, bishop c5, and after e5, knight d5, knight d5, queen g2, very important intermediate move, rook f1. I should simply take here with the queen on d5, and the picture already you can see that black is much better. For sure I will take a pawn back, and I will still have this very strong initiative now. So that's about my game with Navarra. He played d3 after queen h5. Also another game was with knight c3 here, a little bit more complex. But the idea is the same for black. It's to go for exchange of this bishop. Bishop h3. Just few more moves. Bishop h3, queen h3. d3. And simply knight bd7. This is a kind of trademark in these positions to go very fast. Especially to take this d-file. And after d4, queen g2 is possible. Rook f1, need to play, after which, just after long castle, knight e3, we take the pawn back. Okay, it's playable. I like this position with black, and I think you should like too. That's about this move when the knight goes back to c2. Also, he can try here, for example, to play e3. The c3 has the bad point of this move is that they give us already, they weaken the white squares with this move. So we can try to use it immediately by playing bishop g4, queen c2, knight a6, increasing the pressure. Now knight wants to go either to b4 or to c5 in order to get d3 later. So Knight c3. Knight b4 anyway. Knight d5. This was everything played. Knight c2, knight c2. And cd5. Already black has advantage here. It was Checkro van den Doel, 2005. So that's about this side moves on queen d5. Of course, the best for him is to go knight b3. Back to b3, then same. We were doing just the same, like against knight c2, we play queen h5. And here we will examine the thing when they don't allow us to exchange the queens, when they play h3. Then it's good, very good square for the queen is on g6. From here we protect this our pawn on e4, which is very important, of course. And sometimes we can organize some attack on the king side by playing h5, h4. Let's see. After queen g6, knight c3, knight a6, a3, knight c5, short castle, bishop e7, knight c5, bishop c5, b4, and bishop b6. Okay, we have absolutely normal position. I don't think black has any problem here. He has clear development, all pieces out. Next move will make short castle. It's easy also to defend this pawn on g4, on e4. So on queen c2 always we will have this tactics with e3. So I mean, this is just good situation for white, for black, I'm sorry. But on 8h3 also, just I want to show you one more game of Hismatulin with black. Denis Hismatulin, strong player, he played it with black. He on h3 he played simply bishop e7, on knight c3 queen g6, and his opponent Matlakov, he played d3. After e d3, e4, short castle. It's clear that white wants to build this strong pawn center with the strong pawn on e4, but white is little bit back into development behind queen c2, knight a6. You see, we are going with the tempos everywhere. a3, bishop e6, bishop e3, bishop b3, queen b3, bishop c5. And thanks to the fact that the king is still in the center, white simply is not in time to finish development. After bishop c1, bishop d4, black has big advantage, huge advantage, because knight comes to c5 and everything is hanging. We can take on c3, on e4, and so on. That's about this knight f3, which I would say that it's not the best move. I mean, we simply can go for e4, d5, take our tempos. Important to remember that we place our queen to h5, where it's very unpleasant, annoying for white, the presence of the queen there. We can attack with bishop h3 and weakening this king side. And also, if they play h3, we can just simply go queen g6 and very fast finishing development. Thanks to the fact that we have this control in the center, we are very free in our development. Our both bishops are open, completely open, and it's enough squares for all pieces.